while not present here. It is imperative to Scion Capital to create a dynamic and custom-fit portfolio for our clients to sustainability. We knew that a portfolio had to cater to the needs of the entire family, which includes Mr. Reiki, his wife, Mr. Dega Chen Reiki, and their lovable pet, the Nojoy mascot, Dexter. So earning short-term profits to donate to ASPCA was one of our main objectives. We also carried out a quick social media search, which showed us that Mr. Reiki loved to go for runs and was very careful about his health. In fact, his favorite app after Nojoy was Runkeeper, a fitness tracking app. Taking it a step further, our tech analyst, Rizwick, used the software to analyze Mr. Reiki's 7,000 plus tweets. We found that Mr. Reiki used several different words, but amongst his favorites were product, which he used 291 times, and many others, as shown in the word cloud. We could gauge his vast experience in the software and IT industry, his keen interest in the consumer-centric service sector, and that he values sensible business models. This led to our investment strategy, the swaying iceberg model.
The swaying icebergs model does exactly what the name suggests. It is based on changing the iceberg and adapting to the situation in the market. Our constantly swaying iceberg consists of 8 layers which help create a custom fit portfolio for our client, Mr. Reiki. I know it sounds like a lot, but don't worry, this one won't sink the Titanic.
The first layer of our model is the country filter. We decided to invest in India as well as the United States because of the healthy economic outlook and rapid growth rates. Initially, as inexperienced investors, we made the mistake of investing in firm plays in China without fully grasping the idea of reverse takeovers or checking the Danish end scope, which would have told us how these particular firms had manipulated the financial data. We decided not to invest in Britain because of its unclear strategy.
We utilized a 2-tier sector filter which contains steeple analysis and protospy. Steeple analysis gave us a deeper understanding of all the sectors, and protospy forces were very essential as it gave us a deeper understanding of the effect of different forces on each sector. After careful consideration, we were able to reject 2 out of the 9 sectors.
Let's discuss our long-term strategy. We decided to use 20 ratios to evaluate all our stocks. However, that turned out to be very time-consuming and inefficient. So, using the same ratios that analyze risk, return, strength, liquidity, and profitability, we came up with a proprietary S-score, a single value that gives us an overall assessment of any stock. The closer the value is to 1, the better the stock is. What makes the S-score so excellent was our innovative approach to the ratios we decided to use. For example, although traditionally R-squared is used to compare data to a benchmark, we, as forward-looking investors, decided to use it as a risk measure. This is the code that our tech analyst Rizwick wrote to fetch real-time stock data using AlphaVantage API. This is a representative of what a CSV file from AlphaVantage looks like. We use this method to input real-time stock data for our S-code formula.
This is the code that we use for the Twitter sentiment analysis software. A query with the name of the firm was entered, along with the count for the number of tweets to be looked through. The output was the number of positive, negative, and neutral tweets that mentioned the firm. This is a heat map for the sentiment analysis of Under Armour, where the green dots show positive tweets and the blue dots show negative tweets. As you can see, an overwhelming majority of tweets show positive emotions. Using sentiment analysis further helped us understand how confident the market was in a particular stock. We now come to our short-term trading strategy. For an effective short-term trading strategy, we decided to use a deep neural network for machine learning-based oscillator analysis. We trained our model using historical data from the past 5 years to provide accurate outputs for inputs. With these oscillators as the input layer, the neural network computed in the hidden layer and outputted the possible trade data. In addition to this, we tried to predict the future day movement of the S&P 500 index, to use in addition to our deep neural network. These are the 14 technical indicators for whom historical data for the past 15 years were used to create the data set to train our machine learning algorithm. Data from 2004 to 2017 was used to train the algorithm. Data from the first 9 months of 2018 was used to test the algorithm. And from then on, we fed in data every day while using the algorithm. We tested 3 possible algorithms for their accuracy percentage, F1 score, and area under the curve RST. After considerable testing, we decided that the neural network is our best option. Had our machine learning algorithm been in charge of an automatic trading system from January to September 2018, which was our test set, we would have gained a cumulative return percentage of 9.92% if our model had bought on prediction of an upward movement and sold on prediction of a downward movement. This, coupled with our qualitative analysis, will obviously help us yield the return percentages that we desire. This is the code that we use for the analysis of a stock on the Stock Twits platform. The output gave us a JSON file with all the tweets that mentioned the ticker of the firm. This, along with our heuristics way of thinking, helped us analyze trader sentiments and bearish bullish predictions to assist us in our portfolio management.
Using different portfolio applications and putting each portfolio's standard deviation and percentage return on a graph, you can see a concave graph being formed. The Black-Scholes model, along with our meta-heuristic insights, allowed us to choose a portfolio allocation that suited the amount of risk we were willing to take and lay on the efficient frontier.
Let us take a deeper look into one of our goals. We present to you Kevin Plant's brainchild and our favorite position, Under Armour. So this is the X-score for Under Armour, which is 0.8969, a very low value to one, making it a good stock for our portfolio.
What you see here is a video of a program where we enter the ticker, Alpha Vantage gives us the ratios, and we calculate the S-score, here 0.8969.
Why was the resounding question we sought out to answer? And to answer it, we used tools such as the McKinsey 7S and SWOT analysis to analyze each and every one of our stocks. The following is the SWOT and McKinsey 7S analysis of Under Armour. Under Armour CEO Kevin Plank's exceptional leadership style of hiring new leaders and focusing on open communication is the reason behind the company's exponential growth. Strong systems and departments in place help the company develop strategies and solve problems like the company's international expansion. Furthermore, all of its employees are ardent believers in its mission, which is to empower athletes.
From the beginning, Under Armour has focused on innovation-led growth and R&D, which ranges from creating sportswear to enhancing athletes' performance to effective marketing strategies. Falling shipping prices, locking down NBA superstar Stephen Curry as brand ambassador, and selling merchandise to more than 375 athletes, and Team Canada in the 2018 Winter Olympics led to a huge increase in sales.
On 21st of February, during a college basketball match, Duke star freshman player and projected NBA's number one pick, Zion Williamson, sprained his ankle as his Nike shoe broke 2 minutes into the game. This caused Nike's market cap to fall down to $3 billion. Adidas's Jim Capital is one of the 10 people facing criminal charges in a federal investigation. He's been sentenced to 9 months in prison.
These are our final sector and stock allocations based on an exclusive S-score and machine learning quantitative analysis, both of which go hand in hand with our in-depth qualitative analysis and meta-heuristic way of thinking.
Otis was an extremely intuitive platform that helped us grow from inexperienced novice traders to slightly more experienced ones. Getting to know the platform was quintessential for our strategy. However, we failed to account for the 15-minute gap, which led to some lost returns.
We focused on radical transparency and idea meritocracy, and always reached consensus through dialogue, deliberation, and openness. No Joy and Ruby Finances were some of the systems which assisted us in making these well-thought-out decisions. In cases of disagreements, not one of the team members ever objected to a vote, a testament to the team's professionalism.
We came up with a team which contained incredible individual talent. But that's not all we bought to do. We bought our personalities. Our portfolio manager, Manav Dixit, vice portfolio manager, Sara Bhatia, tech analyst, Ritvik Rai, long-term analyst, Meher Arora, short-term analyst, Harshana Khandelwal, firm analyst, Adhiraj Vich, and IT sector analyst, Sara Bhatia.
Before we become an elite firm with elite clients, we need to be an ethical firm with strong values to attract any clients at all. In a school with multiple teams participating and limited classroom space to share between them, we gave our competitors the utmost privacy and respect. This was our way of upholding the integrity of the competition.
Because of this experience, we learned a lot about investing and the stock market. So we felt it necessary to share our newfound knowledge with our peers. This compelled us to start a finance club at our school. This is a picture from the first session on the importance of financial literacy.
As we sign off today, all team members of Scion Capital can agree that this competition has been the highlight of our lives for the past few months. In hindsight, we would have liked to find our footing quicker and started trading earlier. However, we have learned more than we could have ever imagined. We possess more knowledge of the stock markets right now than we could have ever hoped for, and are walking away from this experience as not only better traders, but also extremely happy competitors. Thank you.